All right, that's enough of that. Hello, Karen Zoid.
I love you madly all the time.
Hell yeah. How you doing, man?
I'm cool. I'm having a beer. I worked hard today. Cheers.
Yes. Yeah, well done. Cheers. I'm unequipped. Mine is en route, so I will I'll cheers you. But congratulations. I just landed and I'm so excited. I'm like a kid at Christmas, and it just shows you the time that we live in now. Because I've done all these broadcasts, and this would slay you, your OCD and the way you, your professionalism. I've been doing all of this on LTE network. Can you imagine running a show that I'm hoping is going to have greatness the size of Zoid Africa, and I started on a LTE modem. I mean, that could change.
The world is that's an analogy for the world right now. The world is running on LTE, man.
Yeah, fuck it.
So we're, no problem there. The 10 out of 10 for it.
The world's running on edge, if anything. We're on edge network at best at the moment.
Am I maybe the person that's causing it to slow? I will move to my router. Shall I move?
Well, you haven't cut out this far, and I want you to be comfortable because ons gaan praat vanaand, but it hasn't cut out on my side, so we're good. And because I've got fiber,
okay,
hold on.
Then I'm going to go back to my
bedroom.
Yeah,
go back, go and chill. Hold on, okay. I want to say it like this. I've got fiber. Yes, I've been wanting to say that for the longest time ever in the world. And I came back and I had to take it out the Dursi and then plug it in and go, oh shit, but now we've got settings, and you know normally that takes 2 seconds. Unfortunately, I've done this so many times that it was fine and I managed to get it going. So how are you today? How are you this fine day? Congratulations on deserving your beer. You definitely need it. And how are you?
I'm very good. I had a great day.
Okay.
I haven't had many great days. Today was fantastic, so I'm celebrating it. Okay. I did a workshop at the studio today, a writing workshop. It was fabulous. It was so rewarding, and people were sharing all their ideas and their thoughts. And we just played the whole day from 9 to 3.
Lekker.
It was fun.
How many people attend? Yeah. How many people, like, do people sign up for this, or was it your creative team, or?
It was on a whim. Last Thursday, I was at studio with Henry, and we were bored, you know.
Yeah.
And then I just made. I bought a new little Rodecaster Pro podcast setup, and I made like these funny voice notes, similar to what you're doing, you know, with sound effects and stuff for your intro. I just sent it to 4 friends and said that I'm doing a creative workshop. If you know anybody who'd like to come, I'm only going to have 20 people because it's not really nice if it's too big.
Mm.
And then we got 20 people.
Lekker.
So it was lekker. We had lunch and it was, COVID safe.
Beautiful, man.
It was
just
nice just to be with other creative people for a day. Yeah.
How often do you find yourself commuting to and from the mothership? Is it quite a lot?
I'd go in well, since last year, I started going in more. You know, I used to go in maybe once or twice a week. Now I go maybe three or four times a week.
Okay.
I'm working from there. Yeah.
Without giving your address away, how long is the journey on average? Is it about?
It's not far. No. It's, you know, I like, I love working at home, but, you know, it's just nice. I've got all my amps and my guitars there, my recording set up, and the cameras are there. And it's better. Three out of the four of us in the band have kids.
Yeah.
And the people that work at the studio, geez, half of them also have children. So it's good for grown-ups to hang around with other grown-ups, you know, the same way that it's good for kids to go to a school that's only kids. So it's like, it's our playroom. And, you know, I found that if I actually just go there with the intent to create, I end up doing stuff and making things, and it's good for me.
Right.
You know? Yeah.
Well, fantastic. Yeah. Well, cool. Well, I mean, it's nice to have a workspace. I've turned my dungeon. You still don't want to come in because you're scared of. Wait till I get Jeffy on the camera
dog.
Just now. Wait till I get Jeffy on here just now, and then you see how cute he is. You're actually gonna break the
phobia of those Alsatians. Oh my word.
Phobia. Our name is Scutterball, Karen. Our name is Scutterbully. You don't give a shit. You don't care. Yeah, here's our son saying hello. Can you read on the screen? Are you getting these comments? Okay, I reckon Bucky.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll say.
Is he Lord for me?
That's Majorzi. Let me put it up again.
Majorzi.
What other part?
Not at church anymore. Not at church anymore now.
Yeah, exactly, Majorzi.
Lord for me.
You must. I think it meant it's the Lord for me. That's what I'm going to call it. That's what I think.
Or maybe Leaf. Maybe he meant
Leaf. It's a Leaf for me. Yeah, but he's such a Christian that even when he says Leaf, it becomes Lord.
He's committed. It's great.
Oh, there. Look. There we go. He says, look. Whoops. I meant Leaf.
Hold on to your hat. Yeah, I knew it.
But Josie, you're so sweet, man. Yes. Yeah.
I want to come and play on your boat. Tell me what you're doing with the boat.
Okay, come.
What are you doing?
Yes, see, it is. It's beautiful, Karen. I can't lie anymore. I've had moments of wanting to, and I must say, when January came around after not having worked from December and being a month-to-month survivor my whole life, as we all have been, as I'm sure, and I was sitting there going, what are you doing playing this rich man's sport? you're a rocker. You're a male rocker in the southern tip of the arsehole end of the rock and roll world. And what are you doing? And I've had moments where I've just gone, no, you have a yellow mobile fork in your corp. And so have many of my friends and people who care about me. Just to make a couple of things clear. It's mainly owned by the bank. I'm fucking overextended that it could fall out. It could fall out from under my feet in 20 seconds. But this is the life that I've chosen to live. And the answer is, I have a beautiful boat. She is so cool. For those of you who don't know, let me see if my comments work. You just go at follow Tim. Tim SV. So Tim stands for The Impossible Machine.
The Incredible Machine.
The impossible machine. Yeah.
Love that.
Okay, so he's in van die honde. Okay, I'll get the camera organized just now, but let me... Kan ek eers klaar... Ek praat met Karen, asseblief. Los my, ek het nou net... Okay, yes, okay, wacht. So, the boat is beautiful, and you must come pull in. I hope you... Have you done a bit of sailing? How your sea legs?
I'm okay. But are you doing like... Are you recording or are you playing on it? Are you jamming?
I haven't yet. Like and when you see her, you'll understand that it's so boats are, they do not follow your timeline and your desires unless you buy a little canoe. So I unfortunately bought a fucking liner. It's a liner. It's 1 foot shorter than the Titanic. It's far too big. It's far too mental. I should never have done it, but I'm so happy I did. So only now am I going to be able to. Put the studio on that I wanted to, and my dear friends at Yamaha. Ooh, he coming! Bye, Dr. Aline.
No.
Now it's Friday. Is it Friday yet?
No, it's Thursday. Don't worry.
Cheers. Cheers, darling. Thank you. So she's cool. So my friends at Yamaha Music are gonna kit her up with some lacquer studio gear. But obviously, you know, I can't have any of these lacquer toys that you've got in your studio because they'll rust in 2 seconds. So the whole thing has to be, it's all laptop based. It's all mobile. It's all has to be wrapped away nicely, and I'll have some lacquer little MIDI controllers. Oh shit, I've actually got something funny to show you. I'm just worried that I came back and there's a little hole next to my aircon. I don't know what has happened. I think my legend, Andrea, who stays here, must have watered a plant a little bit longer than he should have.
Yeah.
But I picked up the MIDI controller like this and I went like this. She can get water.
Oh, my word.
So I mean, it's hard enough keeping shit dry in a dungeon.
No.
It was just a cheap little MIDI controller. Thank goodness. But anyway, so the point is, there is going to be a studio. It's going to be beautiful. We must record. And the main thing is, I want to kind of, because I've also got Wi-Fi on board, and I've kind of like figured this little thing out, which is relatively easy to configure. And I want to do more jams like this, yeah, where we can actually do it in the flesh and super COVID distance. And you sit at the other side of the couch. That's one of the cool things about a big boat. I want to do little songwriting getaways. If you wanted to do what you did in the studio today, but have it very, you know, also just a little bit more bespoke. That's what she's set up for. So the main thing is, she's ready. Funny. She's ready to go. She's beautiful.
How many people can be on the boat without it feeling like sardines?
So her actual rating is 12 passengers and 3 crew. She has 13 bunks, like big, spacious. I mean, she has 4 bedrooms. 4 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms. It's a bit crazy.
So you can sleep on the boat.
Yeah, natürlich. Look, I remember at your show. Yes. I don't know if you remember at your show when I did it. You said, what are some of the things you want to do? And even as I was saying it at your show, I was going, yes, yeah.
Clink. I remember.
Yeah, clink mal. But I said, I want to sail around the world. So I'm busy preparing that, Karen. I'm busy prepping my boat, and I'm going to be hopefully going around the world. Within a year, I might cast off. But until then, I'm just going to have some fun. I've got an unbelievable berth at the V&A. And so I'm chartering. I've got a Category A commercial license for her.
I walked past it the other day. I have seen your boat. I've seen it. I didn't realize that people can sleep on it. You're actually
going to go. There's a thing. So the thing is, you must pull in. It's very cool. And we'll do some more jams. The next time we do something like this must be from the deck, right on the deck of the boat. But yeah, I must say, Cape Town, you know, Cape Town's got horrendous weather. I mean, I love this place, but the weather is nuts. So we have to find weather windows, and we have to get the right time to go on. You're frozen a little bit. It might be time to migrate back to your kitchen. We've got your audio perfectly. Okay, Karen, head back. If you can hear my voice, head back to the router. Whoa. We can hear you. That's the good news. There we are. Perfect. Sorry about that. I think, oh, no, she's gone. She just clicked goodbye. And that is the power of online interviews. She will be back in a second. And I can't wait to do this face-to-face with guests on the boat. But to those of you who are here and while she calls in, cheers. Thank you for joining me. I just landed. Literally, my arms are killing me. But happy Thursday. And I missed the bottle store. So I have, fortunately, we found a lot of friends during lockdown. So a friend just dropped off some Jameson. Thank you, Grant. I do appreciate Grant Van Zyl. Here she is. Karen is back in the house.
What happened?
I think you went. I don't know. I think you went too far from the router, love. Unfortunately, you do have to.
Okay.
It's a bit. But now you must get a comfy chair and put it. I mean, we don't mind walking around with you.
I'm going to sit in my kitchen. I hope it doesn't make too much noise.
It should be fine.
It's a bit reverby in here, but it's okay. I heard your opening was very reverby.
let me match my audio to your kitchen. What? There, that's how your kitchen sounds. Hello, dog.
Tell me something.
Yeah.
Describe to me your opening jingle. Exactly what is going on? All those noises and things.
Well, you know what? Craig. You know Craig Reed, who was my manager for a long time. He's just so cool, and he just
yeah.
He just designed this thing just out of the blue as a little like placeholder for me. So while you're busy sharing the event, which I thank you very much for doing. Oh, while I have people here, can I ask you a big favor? What one way to support an artist, apart from this whole stars thing, which is also new brand as new to me as anything else, can you please just scroll down on your page and just click the little share button? It means the world. It would be, I don't even know where to share it. Maybe do a watch party or whatever, but while you guys are watching us, that would really, really help me. So I appreciate that. But yeah, so okay, where were we? I was talking about, does Tim need a cook? We've got people. The boat. Check out. I'm just gonna pour this in. So people, this is Mensa. This is how this works. Did you watch Skulk's podcast or his Instagram post in the morning? Day 35, lockdown. No. Yes, he's got. Have you not? Yeah. Yes, cock's not. So.
Yes. Yeah, brilliant.
He always starts his thing
feeling,
with Mensa.
Feeling positive.
Yeah, feeling good. What does he say? Feeling good, feeling positive.
Feeling positive, yes. Yeah, that's it.
So I've just.
So great.
Oh, shit. It doesn't look like these comments. Okay, I'm going to comment on. Brilliant. Word, you soon. Yeah. We're getting double stuff here. So there's a. We're going to do something quite radical. Oh, lekker disco. Ian Beer, eh? Net Ian Beer. And your face mask turns into a disc.
Just a bandana off the face mask.
I love it.
This is the Roaring Twenties, baby.
I love that. That is so versatile. Okay, so I've posted on the page. I've posted a link. So guys, just but you have to highlight it and then open it in a Chrome browser, or I think Safari should work, or anywhere on your phone, but don't click the link in this. And then you can surprise Karen and I. Don't be rude, because I'll cut you off immediately. I have all the control. Let me say that again with my reverb. I have all the control. So you can phone in and you can speak to us and we can have a threesome online. When last? Okay, probably not one of the... We'll obviously cut that out in the live stream. So please call us in anytime, guys, but you have to copy and paste it in. I will see you in a green room. You might have to hang around there. Please use headphones and please be lekker, be nice. This is all about love and kindness. And then, speaking of love and kindness, so Karen, you'll appreciate this. I've started this whole thing from scratch. I had no idea what I was doing, trying to do. And after the second show, I had these amazing people jumped on as sponsors. Like, I was like, whoa, you mean one day I can make money like the great Karen, except nowhere near your level yet. No, but you know what I'm saying? So, but in this media, in this little format, I had no idea. I was literally just, I was talking to Arno one night, and you know him, he was smoking a joint, he got all scared. I was like, shit, we don't have to get scared anymore. First of all, we're unemployed. It's not like we're going to have any less work. So you can. You can. Yeah,
they were never going to be able to fire us anyway.
Exactly. So you can smoke your jointy, more lekker and gemakkelijk. Anyway, turns out I got a great sponsor. They've been amazing. They've supported. They've seen the show. They are amazing. And tonight, they have continued very kindly. They have given you the power. Let me see. I've got to use my reverb. I've just found it. The power to give 5,000 Rand cash to any one of the comments of the people on the stream. And I'm going to bring up, obviously, everyone's in trouble. Everyone needs cash. We all do. I might use my pseudonym account and put my motivation on you as well and hope. And I'll just try and hint a lot that you choose that. But if you tell us why Karen needs to give you 5,000 Rand, there's a company called Pay Just Now, and I'll explain more. There's their website, payjustnow.com, are doing that. And that is just a little supplement to what they're doing to the show. They are so rad. They're the coolest guys who run the show. And they give you 3 months to pay the stuff interest-free. I'll explain how it works. It's actually amazing, but I don't want to ruin this right now. But I just want to plant that in Karen's brain quickly. 5,000 Rand to whoever you think needs it the most. So it comes. I'm going to put up some comments as we're talking, and if it happens to be, this is your show. You can't read the comments. I'll put the comments up. I'll put them, and then you can see them on the. Then you can see them on the phone. No one's asked for it yet. So no one wants money yet. So if no one asks for the money, then I get it. We split it. We go to the casino later. Daai knoppie gedruk. Karen, jy het weer gemute. Jy moet... Ek druk hom weer. You've done it again. Do what you did last time. Druk hom. Druk hom. It's still not there. It's gone. Druk hom weer. Ach nee. Ach nee, wat. The guest has muted. Okay, she's calling back. This is sensational. I don't care. I've got fiber. This is a high. Five in the rank is for you, Werner. Wonderlijke mens. You can't just say, I want the money, Adrian. You have to ask for it nicely and tell us why. You have to, Okay, Karen, you're not allowed to leave. You're not allowed to leave the show again. You're not allowed to leave the page.
Okay, I won't. Sorry, I was just curious. I thought that I would be able to look at the comments, but clearly you're the king of this castle. Okay.
So check out. Like, would you respond to someone who just goes, first of all, this is kak funny. Ik kom 5,000 rankies for mate. That's very funny, Vanna. I don't know if it's enough of motivation to pull on the heartstrings, but a good effort all the same. Who was this? Okay, Adrian. Adrian, what are you thinking? I mean, what motivation is that? What appeal is that to Karen's inner kindness?
Yeah, I want the money.
Yeah.
There's a little bit Jacob Zuma there.
Yeah. And he come on that note, he has another comment coming up.
Pay back the money, yes.
Okay, Carlos. Okay, you're right. It's my boys. Okay, well, I'm going to put up a bunch of comments, and then I want to just talk to you. This is just a little game we play in the meantime, just so you can have a couple, and then
it's my boy's birthday.
Appreciate it, DJ said. I mean,
I like this.
I actually do like that.
Okay. That is nice.
Okay.
Look, firstly, it's someone who wants to give it to somebody else.
Yes.
Secondly, the thing they want to give it to that other person is the gift of music.
Yes.
And since Musica has closed its doors forever and ever.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe we should give it to her.
I like it. Crescentia. Yeah. Now keep that. Have you got a little pen? I'll write it. I actually do. Look how organized I am. I'm going to put this down for you.
Okay.
I'm going to write this. Oh, fuck. What's my pen? Nee, wat. Yes. You know, I go away for one day and I come back and the studio is exactly the same and I can't find anything. Okay, hold on. Fuck it. Okay. Crescentia. You can't forget Crescentia. I like that.
Crescentia's in the lead.
Can I suggest that Crescentia is going to have to, he or she is going to have to then come back on this chain at some stage with a picture of said DJ set that was bought for said kid.
Good idea.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Otherwise, maybe Crescentia is going to meet you and me at Grand West in about 2 or 3 hours.
Grand West.
You're gonna be like, Crescentia, hang on. Aren't you supposed to be shopping for DJ stuff at the moment? So okay. So if we do choose something like that, then I think then you need to he's in. I think 5,000 Rand should be I'm gonna move this to the arts. All artists are struggling and rely.
Oh.
That's very kind, but to who, Dane? We need to be a bit more specific. 5,000 Rand going to all the artists will give us about 13 cents each. Which will be more.
Oh, minus. Yeah, there's lots of us.
Okay, so here we go. We got a cool little. We got someone in the green room, but I'm watching her. Mm-hmm. I don't know how you pronounce it. It looks like Swane, Suane, with a copy on the E thing. What do you call that in Afrikaans? The E with a copy key on it.
Suane. Suane. A grafis of a akit. Akit of grafis.
Oh, a grafis of an akit. Okay, but now Suane, you must now your camera lekker aanset, asseblief.
Suane.
Swane, ja. Dis, maar ek sien nou hier in die groen kamer nie. Okay, daar is hy. Daar, Swane, amper daar. Get as close as you can to your modem. I can't bring you into the show while you're pausing like that. Okay, you're looking good. That's getting better. Okay, hier kom sy. Headphones and everything.
Okay.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the interwebs, very randomly, Karen and I have no idea. I've only just figured out how to pronounce it. I introduce to you Swane, wach. In oomlik, I'm doing all the broad bloody casting myself while I'm holding a whiskey. Swane, hoe gaan het met jou?
Goed, dankie, en julle?
Hi, goed en self.
Lekker, welkom. Where are you calling from?
Limpopo, Morimole.
How very cool, welcome.
Okay, lekker.
Wat wil jy vir Karen sê?
Suane, spreek ons sy naam Suane uit, want ek weet is nie Suane nie.
Suane, yes, okay, cool.
So you were dead right, Karen. Look at you and your Afrikaans. I mean, unbelievable.
Kou van jou oorfone.
Okay, dankie. Ek leen dit met my kind.
It's cool. It's lekker. Lekker wie op pad is na party toe. Of jy by silent rave of iets is. Cool.
Swana, what do you do for a living, if I may be so bold and forward?
I'm a legal typist, so I spend my days behind the computer.
Oh, cool. And can you explain more what that means? I don't know what that means. Do you draw up like contracts and stuff like that?
I don't do it myself. So yeah. I work for an attorney, so they dictate for me and I do the rest of it. Behind the scenes.
I wish I could have you behind the scenes for the show so you could put up all the links and stuff like that while I'm buggering around here. That sounds very cool, man.
I do ads and stuff as a side job. So.
I say, okay, cool, man. Mm. Okay.
Some creativity as well. Not just living under dictatorship in Limpopo.
No. Cool. Yeah, I'm really bad at it as well.
So Karen, you know that you're not just my friend and guest, you're actually a co-host, and I know you have all the experience in the world. So this is our show. So how else should we be interrogating the delightful young Swanee? What else do we think people would want to know about her?
I would like to ask Swanee what the best part and the worst part of 2020 was.
Okay, that's a good question. I threw up a motivation here quickly. Wacht, Swanee, jammer, laat ik niet... We'll get back to you, Mark, sorry. Okay, off you go, Swanee, jammer.
Okay, best part of 2020. Rediscovering family and friends. Worst part, discovering the hard parts of yourself and dealing with.
Yeah, that's a good common answer. Can I ask something? Have you done anything? And I am going to ask Karen this later, so I'm going to give you a heads up on this question. Have you done anything in particular to keep yourself healthier? Did you get COVID? Do you know anyone who's had it around you? Or have you been able to avoid it? And if so, have you done anything in particular because avoid it?
We've been isolating most of the time. And I have family that's had the virus as well. So we've avoided them. But as far as that goes, that's about it. No, we haven't had it ourselves, luckily, because we work with people every day. So we are fortunate to miss it. But for the rest, everyone else survived that we know.
Sure. Thank you, toch. Well, that is good to know. How many kids do you have? Explain the family dynamic for us.
Two kids, 8 and 9 years old, and they are giving me grey hairs. So, Guy, here we go.
But they're giving you headphones as well, so it's a fair trade, you know. I mean, grey hairs and free headphones. I mean, I'll take that.
Yeah.
Okay, lekker. Well, Swanee, thank you so much for joining us. I really appreciate it. I appreciate you learning how to copy and paste a link, which I'm trying to tell people how to do in case you'd like to do that. But you nailed it. And obviously you got your kids around to help you guide you, but we're wishing you all the very best. Continue to be strong and good luck with whatever you've been doing. Thanks for supporting little initiatives like that. And I'm sure the South African music that you have, we really appreciate you for that.
Okay. Thanks for having me.
Thank you, Swanee.
Thank you, Swanee. Luck on, Father.
Cheers, bye.
Cheers, bye.
You see, Karen, so that's what we do. We're random people from around the world, unvetted, unprocessed, unscreened. And I must say, here's my guitar. Touch wood. We haven't had too many weirdos. The only one that was a legend, so not a weirdo, was the act that we called the first time we ever tried this with Arno. It was some homie in Durban, and he obviously got so excited to see Arno smoking a joint that he was like, okay, this is my moment. Are you kidding? And he lit up this Christmas tree. And he's like, "This is vanaand gaan ek saam met Tromme praat." And he was so blazed. He's, I mean, you could have, You could have blindfolded him with dental floss. His eyes were so, he was full Chinese. It was cuck funny.
Oh, shit.
Okay, so hold on.
That's a naughty.
So we're on a roll. So, Karen, you are already breaking records, yeah, being the legend that you are, and everyone wants to talk to you. So we've got a Kaylee in the background, and I'm pretty sure this one I'm not mispronouncing. Ooh, one whiskey, check out. Okay, Kaylee, jy moet nou 'n bietjie stil raak, en jy moet iewers neersit asseblief. Is dit ewen hoe jy sê dit? Of jy moet net sit, nie neersit nie. Sit die kamer. Okay, daar sê. Have you got headphones on? I can see in the green room there. What? Okay, if you don't have headphones on, just make sure that the volume on whatever phone you're using is nice and low. Okay, hier kom sy. Kaylee, in the mix. Daar sê. Wag. Kilo hier, kilo daar en Kaylee daar. Hallo daar.
Kaylee, hello.
How are you guys doing?
We're good.
What are you doing, Kaylee? What are you up to?
Well, I mean, I'm also like just waiting for university to start at the moment. I'm actually a jazz student. So yeah,
a jazz student.
Yeah.
Okay. What instrument do you play? What instrument do you play?
So I actually mainly do saxophone, and my second instrument is guitar. So yeah.
Wow.
Cool. So explain the course. What do you have to do?
So with Tux, there's normally it's a normal BMS 4-year degree. So it's a lot of fun. We get to do a whole bunch of stuff like music technology and music education, and at the end of it, I actually want to end up doing music therapy.
Amazing.
It's a very fun thing to do. So I thought that I could combine my love of music and psychology and just do something that'll be cool. So yeah.
I think it's
right. Have you got? Do you have your sax nearby? Can you play something maybe?
Not at the moment, but...
Oh.
Hi, Kaylee. Well, that would have been awesome. Well done. You see, Karen, you inspired... That's how you interview people. Like, show us what you're doing. I wouldn't have thought of that for some reason. I don't know. Just because I'm so not music-related with this particular show. But that would have been amazing. So, Kaylee, where are you at the moment? Where do you live?
I live in Pretoria.
Okay, rad. Someone with good internet connection, yeah. Thank goodness. That's pretty rad.
How long have you been playing the sax?
Since I was 9, actually. So yeah, I first started off doing classical, and I did my grade 8 exam, and then I thought, let me do some jazz at university. So yeah, and it was cool. In high school, I did some band stuff, and yeah, it was fun.
And tell me, why did you choose the sax? I mean, it's quite a... I always wonder what the attraction, what was the draw card for you?
So basically, I had a teacher that taught me a recorder, obviously. And then she played saxophone. And then I basically ended up joining a saxophone ensemble at my high school and everything like that. And I wanted to start off with guitar, but my hands were still too small. So I started with sax, and she inspired me. So, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Like, how old are you, Kaylee?
I'm 21.
Rad. Yo, jeez, you do look younger. How amazing. That's awesome. Well, listen, we wish you the best of luck for getting back to some kind of schooling system. I know. I mean, I've spoken to some parents, and it's been a hell sitting. Fortunately, my dogs don't go to school because they all study online, and so I'm lucky with that. Hey, who's that in the background? Wat sê jy? Wat's your name? Wie is dit?
That's my little brother.
Kom sê hallo vir ons. Kom sê hallo vir Karen. Kom onmiddellik. What's your name? What is your name? What's your name?
Tyler.
Tyler, hoe gaan het met jou? Hoekom, why are you being so shy? Come on, get into screen there. How old are you, Tyler?
Yeah,
goodness, Shem. He started grade six this year.
Hello, Thailand. Wow.
Grade six, yes. Those are the three best years of my life, if I remember correctly. Taylor, Kaylee, thank you so much for joining us. Thanks for showing us that this technology works. You see, it's so easy that even grade sixes can copy and paste it. And Kaylee, who says she's 21, but I know she's 16, can also do it on a...
Yeah, Kaylee.
Thank you for validating our show and for calling in randomly and making this extra special call. Is there anything else, last thing you want to say to Karen before I say goodbye to you?
So I wanted to actually ask, you said that you did some songwriting today. Is there any, what is the best songwriting tip that you can give?
Well, if I don't have a lot of time with you, I would say always tell the truth. Okay. And in other words, always write from the heart and make a start, you know. And the other thing, I think people make the mistake, they think it's going to come out perfectly the first time. I think one of the biggest things for me is you have to waste paper to write a song. You have to write it all out and edit yourself afterwards, but never be afraid of writing those cheesy lines. You can always scratch them out later, but let them come out and just let it flow and just get into a state of flow and just play as often as you can. Just, you know, the more you write, the easier it becomes, I think.
I think that's a great advice. That's pretty much exactly what I do. You never, just don't edit yourself. Like, as soon as you get a word or a lyric in your mind, put it down on paper. As Karen says, you can always scratch it out later. So that's interesting to hear that that's your top advice as well. Kaylee, thanks for joining our show. You're a legend. Best of luck with the sax and the guitarists and all that.
Bye, Kaylee.
Bye, Leafies. Thank you. Cheers.
Bye.
Now I need to find a charger or
but Karen, I spoke to you about this.
I'm running low.
I spoke to you.
I'm gonna just.
Okay, my he's okay, Kavani.
Look.
Okay, I'll say. Okay, but now, are you on Bluetooth headphones? Okay, that's working well. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, look what Van is saying.
Hang on now.
Look at the screen.
I can't even beer kry nie, want ek moet eers hier inplug.
Okay. She's one job at a time, Van. She's like it, dude.
The pili key has to go in. There we go.
Were you running? I remember I had Ross on here. He was my second guest, and he was somewhere for his dad's birthday in God knows where, but it was somewhere which couldn't have had more than 2 meg down. And every second frame froze, and it's Ross's beautiful face. So it didn't matter at any angle when it froze. And then the show ended, it just went blank. And I was like, I texted him, I was like, anyway, so that's Ross. So he's out. And he said, sorry, bro, my battery died. I was like, Ross, you've known about the show for at least 24 hours, which for me is a miracle to be able to give anyone that much notice. And and he said, sorry, I'm the thing down. I was like, ay, Rosicky. But the show worked really well anyway. It's amazing we're doing all this from our phones, Karen. It's quite nuts.
I know. It's such a great time of experimentation, you know, at the moment. I mean, there's so many horrible things, but just for a moment to focus on the good things.
Yeah.
I think we've all accelerated towards embracing technology. We've accelerated towards, you know, being a bit more vulnerable with each other and about how we are and how we feel. I think I've never, ever heard so many men in my life actually share their feelings.
I know, right?
As I have in the past. And women, not that I'm saying women are sharing their feelings, but, you know, I think we're all just getting real, hey?
I 100% agree. Like, I have not seen like bravado males going, oh, I love you, bro, like, you mean the world to me, you know. It's that usually only comes like 2 o'clock in the morning after the 50th Black Label, you know, like, I'll kill someone for you if they came. That's like, that was the that was the old narrative. And now you're like, now you're like 8 a.m. in the morning going, hey, bro, I just want to tell you, bro, you mean a lot to me. Big love. And you're like,
just
what?
Just checking in on you.
Just checking in. That's a new phrase. It's amazing.
It's so cool.
It's so rad.
Really cool.
I completely love it. So, yeah. Listen, Karen, we're getting beautiful love. You, I mean, thanks for joining me on this little venture. I've reposted that link on the comment section, guys. Just so you remember, or just so you know, just copy and paste it into a browser and call us. We're here to talk to you right now. And if you talk to us and tell us in the interview why you need 5,000 rand, Karen has the power of the 5,000 rand. Hold on, 5,000 rand. Oh, Eileen. Eileen, my donkey. I've just been handed a bowl of ice and a liter of Jameson. So this interview, this interview is about to get weird. Are you ready?
Okay.
Ek trek sommer nou my hemp af. Wag.
Ooh, No,
we would just see the numbers drop immediately, and then I would just have to end this broadcast all sadly. Okay, so I did want to.
Have you been writing music, eh? Have you been writing or playing or not really?
Fuck no, Karen. I've battled, eh? I must say, not battled. It's just been hard to get my head around being too motivated. And I have one other disclaimer. I've been building a boat, and when you come see this boat, you'll be like, how did you ever manage to get home at night? You know, like, it's so funny that
where was I? Theo was like bitching about you in the boat. You were supposed to be somewhere. Then you go somewhere. Then you were supposed to play golf with him, and then you went off to build your boat. And then you came back and you were supposed, and then you go back to Saldana to build the boat.
Yeah, fuck, that was a thing.
People were talking about it.
It was such a thing. That boat, I mean, it's just amazing. Here's a dear friend of mine. I don't know if you know this name. I went to school with him, Greg Fulyun. Hello, you may have worked with him. He's been in he's an amazing comedian, advertising world, all that space. Anyway, but he's a champion.
I know Greg. He went to film school. Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so
I played tennis with Greg Fulyun. If it's the same Greg Fulyun.
Yes, he's a great tennis player. I know this because he used to devastate me around the court rather easily without giving a shit about how bad I was huffing and puffing. So that's Greg. Shout out to Greg. So you were asking if I've been writing, and the answer is no, but I have been building a boat, and when you do see it, which I can't wait, and I know it's going to be soon, I think you'll understand. And I'm playing golf with Theo on Monday, so he must calm down. So we'll be okay.
Just calm down now, y'all.
Just Theo as a blief, man. Ach, nee. How much do we love Theo, Karen? Can we just give the biggest shout out to Theo Krauss in the world?
So much. Love him so much. Yeah, my heart.
He's just, you know what I'm going to do?
Always.
So the next thing. Okay, so we've got Christian in the green room. Christian, geduld. Blader, hold the course. I can see you look sensational. That beard is amazing. I've got beard envy already, but just give us a second. We're busy doting about Theo, so if you'll give us 2 seconds. Christian's coming in, Karen. We got a looker. Okay? All right.
Okay.
So,
okay.
So Theo, what I'm going to do is, and you must, maybe you can tell me after the show now, because now, oh yeah, here we go. Here's Gavin Minter. We know, Fork and Main. If that's not Theo, through and through. But Gavin, big shout out to Gavin. Love you, boy. What another champion. But one of my very exciting things.
Remember those gigs Gavin used to organize at the Green Dolphin?
No, you see, I wasn't Cape Town based then, Karen, yeah. So I missed out all of that. I didn't know that. I was Durban then, but I know they were legendary. I know they were completely legendary.
Yes, it was nice. It was right there where your boat is parked.
Yes, I heard. Like right
there
at
the La Parada. It's La Parada now or something. That used to be the Green Dolphin.
Yeah.
And Gavin Minter used to have these beautiful acoustic nights, sometimes bands as well, actually.
Oh, here we go. Gavin's reminding us now.
I used to hang out there.
Levi's Vintage Sundays.
It was called.
Yeah. Now say. But where are we going with this? We got other people. Yes, see, Karen, you are super popular. My green room has never been this full ever. Karen, Holt, we got another Karen on the line. Who, if you've got good enough internet, just hang in there, because we've still got to get through Christian. And then we have to get through the beautiful moment of when we all have to get our phones landscaped so four of us can have a foursome. Okay. It helps if there's four of us. Otherwise, it's not a foursome. Okay, so just hang in there. So So let me finish with Theo. So, and you must advise me after this, or just in general. But I want to, and I think he's cool. I think we're all at a place in our lives. I want him on the show again now that I've got fiber. Hold on, I've got to do this. Fiber. Okay. I want him on the show, and I want the complete Theo Kraus story. Can you fucking imagine how riveting that'll be? Live. Just him. Just, but like all the detail we know, yes or no? Okay, think about it. I'm gonna get Christian in the meantime. Yes, we got
awesome.
I think it'll be obviously only if he wants to, but I think it'll be the greatest fucking interview ever. Theo's got one of the most legendary stories that are actually a success story as well. I think it'll be great.
Theo was that guy who just pushed it. You know, when he's great now, but I mean, he would also admit, you know,
he pushed it
very, very close to the edge. So close to the edge. Way too hard.
Lucky
to be alive, honestly.
So I don't mean to laugh, but he knows that. He knows that, which is why I think, I mean, can you imagine this? I mean, how is this format not the best way for him to share his story and help and advise people that there is such a thing as too much, and there is, you know, we need to try and find our off switch, because so anyway, I think it's gonna be great. Eileen Stemsom and Ekville, no for Christian.
The Theo Kraus story.
I think that'll be sick. Anyway, that's gonna happen. I think it's gonna happen anyway. Christian is here. How would you say Ekville for yellow Christian on beat? Is that right? Is that correct? Yeah, voorstel.
Aankondig.
Aankondig.
Voorstel, ja.
Voorstel. Okay. And now, hier is Christian. Wacht, ek wil Christian. Okay, wait. Now I've got to...
Whoa,
wacht. Okay, want het jou stem, maar wacht. Karen number two, we haven't forgotten about you. Just be chill.
Hallo.
Christian, hoe gaan het?
Hi. Goed en julle?
Lekker, man. Goeie naam,
hoe gaan het?
Goed.
Where are you calling from?
Kempton Park.
Yes! Kempton Park. I went to Lota Kubota.
By the airport.
Lota Kubota Kletter School. Is that still around? Can anyone Google that for me?
It is.
Is it really? That's where I learned to speak Afrikaans. Lota Kubota Kletter School. I remember my mom... I used to come back from going to like a couple of months there, and it was fully Afrikaans. And I used to come back with now, at my five-year-old brain, which was the only time that I was actually absorbing information in those days. I used to come back and I was just like in and out of all. And my mom actually literally was worried. She was like, oh shit, my kid is gone. He's completely, he's gone full.
He's gone Afrikaans.
No, that wasn't, she wasn't worried about that at all. She was like worried that I wasn't anything. She was... Are we allowed to say retard on the show? But like, I think she was worried about saying he's gone full confused. So let's take a vote. A big up. Thank you for giving me the Afrikaans as nicely as you did in those days. Christian, what's up, brother?
No, it's good. Just hanging at home and getting the kid to bed. You know, the bedtime routines.
I think
my wife will deal with him.
Okay, right. Just one kid, Christian.
Yeah, for now.
Okay. Jeez, like you are a brave man. Braver than I.
No, it's easy. You just put him in front of a few drums. Ons hang in speel musiek en drink.
Wow. Ek weet, Kempton is
mos maar 'n bietjie... Nee. Ek speel vir jou al.
Nee? Oh, my favorite.
So waar is hy? Speel vir ons 'n liedjie. I'm taking Karen's cue. That's what she would do. She'd be like, speel vir ons so 'n bietjie, man. Kom, Christian, is op die fok wees.
Ek sal, maar julle sal hom nie kon hoor nie.
Ah, it's electric. So plug it in your phone. I know you got an app. You liar. I know you have an app for that shit. That's the only way you do it in the privacy with a child around.
I've got an app for that, but then I have to turn you guys off, and you guys are better.
Okay. Yes, so you're lucky, bro. You weaseled your way out of that, brother. You're very, very lucky.
Yeah, I know. I'm nowhere near camera ready for a violin.
Next time, Christian. Speel jy saam met ander mense? Of is jy in a band?
Yes.
Of is jy in a groep? Ons, of is jy classical?
Ons was... Nee, band jare terug, nog in die MK daar. Toe ek nie 'n baard gehad net nie en nie rare.
Bro. Your beard is amazing, wil ek net sê.
I told you I got beard envy immediately. Wag, incredible. Was my borsel? Ek het 'n borsel. Okay, julle twee gaan aan. Ek soek my borsel.
Okay.
Just see.
Ja,
hoor die Karen, kom daar weer een van die tijd van jou talkshows op Mnet, of wat, op DSTV?
Yes, ja, ons gaan nog een, ons het nog een gekry, dankie Here. Ons is nogal dankbaar voor. Ja, dankie. So, ja, ons gaan weer opneem in die jaar. Ek denk in Mei of Juni, maar in tweede helfte van die jaar gaan dit uitkom, ja. So, ek sal gewoon
exciting stuff.
Om nou uit te zien. Ja, ja.
Christian, you ain't got shit on this. You ain't got shit on this freshly combed beard anymore, bro. Sorry.
Oh yeah, no.
I come this
talk about competitive. Like,
yours can be combed. I'm envious. Mine is just.
Yeah. You need a weed eater or something.
Yeah.
So, Colin, that's great news. So there's another. They've picked up another season.
Yes, yeah, we're doing another one this year. Yeah, so I'm quite amped about that, yeah.
Congratulations, yeah. Christian. I assume you obviously watch the Great Karen Show, do you?
Yes.
Did you ever
watch the Karen Show?
That's obviously the Karen Show. That's the scientific term for
Karen Show.
The greatest Karen show in the world. Sorry, I'm loving this button.
It sounds like a new jingle.
Please can I submit that jingle to you, Karen? Just consider it. You don't have to. We mates. You could tell me if it's not working.
I'm worried about your use of reverb. I'm really really worried. the emotional repercussions of using so much reverb. You're scaring the shit out of all of us.
Okay. It is. We're not living in the right time to be using so much reverb because we're all so on edge.
No. Like, no. People are suffering from anxiety, PTSD. Corona.
Nee, ek's jammer. Fuck it. Kan ek emekie as 'n belief? Nee, kan ek. Kan ek net jammer sê? Ek is so fucking jammer. Okay, there we go. Done. I'm muting it. Will there be no more reverb and we are done. Now it's only ping pong delays which are going to drive everyone but fuck crazy, trust me.
As long as it's not auto-tune, everything is
value
okay.
Value packed the show.
Christian, what a legend. Thanks for calling in, bro. Was that you commenting earlier? I think that was, right?
Oh, yeah, Nick. Yeah, about the drinks.
Yes. Okay, legend. Christian was very worried about the amount of beers that you had, Karen, and I think that sounds like a good.
I had one single.
No, he's worried that you only had one. That was his concern.
Yeah, I
would love to have another, but I'm currently tied to an electrical cable on a couch. Because I've got a child selfie stick. Yeah. When it's charged.
Well, listen, Karen. I mean, Christian and I are more than happy to carry the show if you put it down like gently. I have the power. If it means for you to get to the fridge, I'll do it. I mean, our followers will have people drop off the show by the drove, so don't take too long. But if you feel like carrying the fridge.
Okay. I'm good.
Okay, well, you see.
I don't need alcohol to be social. I'm very happy you're right here.
Me
but
too.
But thank you. Thank you for offering.
Me also. Fuck, okay, I'm pouring this back. You're the one who said we're carrying tonight. This was going to be my off night. I was actually going to be fasting as of tonight. And then you were like, come, is this a kiddie show or what? You led me to the water. And now you make me look like the alcoholic, which isn't hard in the first place.
Okay. Fine.
Donkey.
Talk to your people.
Okay.
Give me 2 minutes and just get a beer. I'll be back. I'm hanging up and I'm coming back. No,
you don't. Okay, perfect. Done. Beautiful.
I have to because I'm charging the phone.
Okay. Hang up.
You
see you now.
Don't go anywhere.
Don't leave us. Karen, don't leave us.
Oh, wait. I'm coming back.
Okay, bye.
I'm coming back.
Okay, bye. Okay, so Christian, we've got a friend called Rourke Kemp is in the green room. We are just going to randomly call him in. This is a musician from Durban. You are now the co-host, Christian. Cool. So you got big shoes to fill.
Well, putting me on the spot.
Yeah, man. Please don't fuck this up. You are now Christian Zoid, okay? Raw K.
Hey, how's it, man? No, I'm alright. How are you?
Very cool. Are you in Durban?
Yeah, in Durban, in lockdown, in perpetuity.
that's how it feels. That's how it feels. We say hello to our temporary co-host Christian, who's on the show, as you've been hearing in the green room.
How's it?
Hi, good to you. So wait, you're a musician. Tell us a bit about the music.
Yeah. There we go. Christian, well done. That was amazing. Natural co-host, bro. Ungelovelijk. Okay.
Just a perfect segue.
Yeah, amazing. Rourke, I mean, I know your music. I'm friends with your father. He obviously waxes lyrical about you and your son. And why not? Why wouldn't you? And I have heard your stuff. It is cool. I can validate that. But what have you been getting up to now during this lockdown of perpetuity?
Yeah, well, I mean, this side, I was quite lucky that I shifted focus about 2-3 years ago towards production. So I was lucky that during lockdown, I started doing lots of like vocal production and like edits and stuff for small bands and sort of like live sessions. And so that's been a lot of the lockdown work. I think there was a weird boom in like September where like gigs came back in like full force. But other than that, I think it's been pretty dry and I think it's been difficult, not just for musicians, but just across the board. I think everyone's feeling it, to be honest.
Yeah, bro, it is. It's true. It's very true. Christian, I'm so sorry. I'm going to have to replace you with the original. You're such a legend. I've got Karen back online.
No. By all means, she is. I'll rather listen to you than watch me.
She's the queen. You've been amazing. I love it. Let's do this again sometime later on. Maybe after midnight we do that. I'm going to say goodbye to Christian, reintroduce Karen to the show. You're a legend. Thanks, my brother. Thanks for being part of this. Bro.
Cheers, man.
Cheers, bye, brother. Bye. And now, with the hostess, with the Moses, who now has another birki, waar is jy? Daar is hy. Dankie.
Hello.
Oh, okay, hold on. Yeah. I've got to get you back in the same place. Daar is hy. Okay, there's the same configuration. Oh. Welcome back. We got Rourke Kemp in the house. Karen, I will tell you that he is a musician that I have seen in person.
Hey, what's up?
He does have some pretty good material, and he was just telling us about how cuck it's been. But Rourke, sorry to burst your bubble. This is not a show about how cuck it's been, because we all know how cuck it has been, and how and how cuck it can be. What I do know is that I don't regret not being in Durban anymore, because with internet like that, that's the reason. But I say that I only got fiber today. I'm joking. You're just getting a little bit pixelated, Rourke. Is there anything you want to say?
It's getting the short end of the stick here.
Yeah, exactly. Is there anything you want to chat to Karen about while we have this forum?
Yeah, for sure. So I did comment earlier. It was funny, my mom was actually watching this live stream, and I think it was actually like the first time she's ever discovered like a live stream and watched it. She like brought it over to me, like, look at this, look what's happening right now. and then obviously you guys asked that question of like who deserves the 5,000 rand, and I commented a friend of mine who's been playing with me for the last 6 to 8 months, as a keyboard player, as a co-producer and writer, and him and his family were incredibly careful, but nonetheless his dad did pass away to COVID. And his mother's a music teacher. So when you did say someone who deserves and needs it, I think in this context, that is just what came to mind. And I know this is a happy show, so I am sorry for bringing that here, but I think it's...
No, that's not be sorry. That's
it's a very real thing.
With now, huh?
Yeah, it is. It is a real thing. It's a real thing. We're sorry to hear that, Rocky. So I'm sure Karen will consider that. And you know, the sad thing is that we've all gone through it. Even those who thought they would be immune to it for some reason weren't. I can share that from my side. I got clapped hard. I got my own little backhand as well. I've always been happy-go-lucky in life, but even I got caught out. Unfortunately, I'm okay. Always going to be okay. And that's something we need to remember. It's kind of a theme that I do kind of refer to a lot, is that we're going to be okay. So yes, this is gnarly. Yeah. We're losing loved ones. We have lost loved ones. We might still lose loved ones, but ultimately we're going to be okay. So I know it sounds weird for me to be able to say that with conviction, but I do that because we will bounce back. We have before, just as a species, if you want to take it that far back. You know, so, but it doesn't mean to say that it hasn't been crazy, crazy tough and a lot to endure. So yeah, bro, just big strength from our side.
Yeah, I think it's important that everyone, I think it's made a lot of people reassess and make sure that they don't take certain things for granted and sort of sit with things. And I think that is something that's good that can come out of it.
Yeah. 100%, bro. Well, listen, please tell your dad, Derek, we say, how's it? He's a legend. You're a legend. Keep going with your music. Just keep writing. Cara and I were talking about what we're doing during this lockdown. So you just keep doing what you're doing. You've got a great skill. And I look forward to showcasing it again some more. And thanks for calling in, bro. I appreciate it, brother.
Laka. Shot so much, guys. Cheers.
Thanks, Rook. Have a good night.
Cheers. So there we go. I mean, Karen, I mean, this is a pretty unique format, right? Just having random folks call in from a link from around the world. Like our first one that we did. Our first one we did.
I love you. You know I love you, Art. Do you know how much I love you? I love you.
Hey, that better fantastic. Not be second beer talk, eh? Is that second beer?
No, that's...
Okay.
No. I love you. I love you in the morning. I love you in the afternoon. Oh. I love you at night. I love the way that you bring joy and happiness wherever you go. You're just such a chilled out person. When you did that show on top of your roof in lockdown, and just the way that you just you're so free, Art.
Ach, thank you, man.
So
Karen.
Free, and it's I love seeing you, and it's lovely to chat to you.
Thank you. Likewise, I've been looking forward to this one in particular for a long time, because it's also just such a different format. It must be so different, you know, from what you do, because you've, with all the biggest respect and compliment in the world, you have such a great structure and a good thing, and I just want to share something also.
No,
with,
but
you
I
know,
mean,
you know,
yeah,
like
no, but I mean, I'm also playing. I've been writing stuff on Zoom. I've been working, experimenting.
You know,
I think it's great. I think it's what we should be doing, and we're not getting it 100% right. But I love it because I think, like, if you're in a band, like you and I started in bands, we sucked for a long time and it was actually fine.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? When you're 16 and you're a band, you suck. And
it's
you,
actually accepted.
You love it. You love it. And it's just being with your friends and playing and being able to do a chord change, you know, and celebrating that. But it's just about trying and doing it. And it doesn't matter when something is pure, you know. I think the world, the veneer is off. We've seen that the curtain has fallen and the world, you know, we've seen through it all. So you don't need to apologize for the show. I think it's wonderful. And I think, you know, people clearly are loving it. I'm loving it. We need to be connected. We can't come over and bri.
Yeah. So yeah.
We need to use this, you know. There's nothing on TV. They're only showing reruns.
Yeah, exactly. Fuck, it's true. You can't do anything. You can't film anything that used to have crowds in it anymore. It's just the weirdest. I must say, I had a little, just this morning, just out of nowhere, and I've been pretty strong. I mean, I can share with you both live and in person. I have already shared that January fucked me up properly, but this morning, while I've completely recovered in every other sense, this morning I just had a little moment going, yesy, man. There's a big facet of our lives that is like, it's gone, eh? In so many ways. Like, if you think about, so let me ask you a completely random question. Like, when are you going to be ready? Not as an artist, But as a fan, like I remember joining with you at the Pixies when they were here. There were however many people at Curse and Wash, 8,000. We were on each other's backs, on his arms. We're clapping, going mull as we do. When do you think in your mind you will feel safe enough and comfortable enough to do that again with 500 people? Never mind 8,000 people. That's a random question.
Yep, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I know. It's wild. So that's my question.
Mm.
We can't even give a date right now.
I think it's that kind of situation where if we keep longing for it too much, it's going to become unbearable. So for me, I have started doing it on smaller scale. Like this songwriting workshop I did today, I literally just did it to do something meaningful and to connect with people. That's what we do as artists, you know. Yeah. That's our job, actually.
Yeah.
We're there to help people forget about the day-to-day, and we're there to help guide them in self-expression, and we express ourselves in that way. So if we're going to long for the days of the big concerts with thousands and thousands, we're going to get depressed. So, but each day we inch closer to each other, be it through this, be it in a physical level, humanity prevails. So, it's very difficult. And look, I don't have it down, but I try not to look at the pictures of us all playing and, I'm trying to move forward. I need to push through this, and I have a lot of people that I need to push with me, carry with, and I'm very much in crisis, you know. I need to look forward. I need to be where I am now and veer forward. Otherwise, I mean, there was a stage last year where I just really got depressed.
Yeah.
I felt like I was going mad.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a very...
I just felt so alone and felt like my life had no purpose. But then I started doing other things. I'm writing an album with someone in New York. I started a beautiful cover of songs. I couldn't write as well, just like you.
Yeah.
Struggled to write, and then I just started making some nice arrangements. And that's when I started going to studio and just going there to go and create for the sake of creating. I mean, none of us are... going at 100%. None of us are making massive amounts of money.
Yeah.
It's a difficult time. But the opportunity is for us to widen our horizons, to experiment, to study. It's we're all open towards this at the moment.
Yeah.
I mean, who would have thought you would have figured out how to do this, whatever we're doing at the moment? And that initiative, and you went on and you did it, and you got a sponsor. Who would have thought? Did you ever in your life think?
Never
you
in my
talking
brain.
Talking to me through a phone.
Never in my brain did I think that.
And giving away 5,000 rand.
And the people that, exactly. I never did I think that I would have my esteemed guest called Jeff finally. Okay, now you can see. This is what you've been scared of your whole life. Hold on 1 second. Hold on. This is not the Alsatian. Granted. Okay, and now my light doesn't want to work. Okay, you have to hold it because you have to see his majesty. Okay, wait. So the flits on as a belief, man. Doing it's. Oh God, I don't know. Forward facing. Okay, wach. Okay, daar zij. Okay. Kom in now. Okay, wach. You have to see this. It's a beautiful thing. Okay. Oh shit.
What are you doing?
I'm putting the camera on Jeff, and I want you to see. Here's Jeff. Kijk, look at my seeing. Kijk zij van mij. Wonderlijk, but his eyes look terrible with a flash. Now he's gonna scare the shit out of you, and he's gonna bring in all these fears of you again. But this is literally called the Jeff Cam. But I should put on the studio light. Jeffy, say hello for Karen and say for all you see Vulti.
Oh, he's smiling.
Oh man, and that's out. That's my scene. It's my blood child. Like he's listen. He has Jeff. Look at this on my chest. Are you kidding me? Like they are my only kids that I have. And they are the sweetest things in the world. And if there's anyone who's going to get you over your phobia, listen, that's it. I understand dog phobias are horrendous. But if there's any dogs that are going to get you over, it's these kids one day. Okay, so one day that'll be, there's the Jeff Cam for now. Oh, kijk.
Thank you.
Kijk. I hope you don't mind him joining us for a little bit. But he's quite a popular.
No, he's very sweet.
He's quite a popular feature on the show. He is the most chilled, and he just doesn't. I've got to get a name for him on the Jeff Cam. But yeah, you know you were talking about, yeah, quite a serious topic before. So Jeff knows when you're getting serious, and he comes and he goes, okay, it sounds like Daddy's getting serious. Jeff, you can't turn your back on us. Could you? Oh, bro, you have no stage etiquette. Jeff, would you please? Jeffy? Wach. Jeff, will you turn? Excuse me, the mensenvol, hello. Nee, hy fucking gelat hier om. Hy is in 'n slap. Jeff, okay, there we go. That's enough already. I mean, look at that. Oh, that oogies. Okay, cool. That's Theo Krause's kit in the background, by the way, which I bought. So don't get anyone get precious about it.
Get any ideas?
Yeah, exactly. So we touched on a serious thing, and if we're going to be serious for a second, again, this is the platform to do it, and why not? Because we've all gone through it. So you spoke about the D word, depression. Listen, we've all been clapped by it hard. And you know me, Karen. You know I've also always been there. I've bounced back from some massive things in my life, but you've always seen me just smile through it and laugh through it, and we all do. Sometimes it's a defense mechanism, whatever the fuck it is. I'm usually very happy-go-lucky, but I got smashed. Yeah. I got smashed hard, and our next problem that we're going to be facing is the mental health issue that people are going to have to deal with as they come through this. So you spoke about it, and it's almost like the next pandemic, you know, that we're going to be facing, apart from the extra fucking face masks that are going into the ocean every day. People, please, can you use a cloth? Look at Karen Zoid's reusable, washable face mask that doubles up as a bloody mask, as a disco mask and a headband. Please, will you use it? These blue things, guys. There we go. Look at that. In one swift maneuver, you've gone from protecting your awesome to looking awesome relevant. Do you know what I mean? Fucks.
And you can protect your arsenal with this as well.
You totally can. Please. You can wear it as a G-string is the rough translation of what Karen was saying. But that's another thing that I'm freaking out about. Those blue masks that you use them once, you throw them in the bin. That freaks me the fuck out, Karen. I'm going to talk to you 2 seconds if you don't mind. I just want to ask you, can you, in your mind somewhere and how, Can you just stand by me? I'm a sailor, so I care about the ocean. I know you care as well, a lot. Can we, just as musicians, as we go forward, you know, unfortunately in our past, we've always had we've had this gift. We go on stage, we've got our backstage rider, and we get given crates of fucking 500 ml plastic bottles, which we get on stage. We go in the middle of the show. We've done it our whole career. So have I. There's no judgment. We've done it. But we drink our little plastic bottle, we chuck it to the side. I say, we have 10 maybe in a show, and the whole band is 100. That's just the fucking show. Those bottles never get used again, and they go into the ocean. Can you please, Karen Zoid, I am asking you, I'm not putting you on the spot, and I'm going to forget all the time. We are going to forget, so it's not like a thing, like if you, it's not a blood vow.
But I agree with you fully.
Can you get a reusable bottle? Can you fill it with water? Can you show the world that you reuse? I now travel with this thing. Wherever I go, it's stainless steel. It's the highest quality you can ever get. It's the most hygienic thing you can ever have. It goes into every bag. Like now, it's like my safety blanket. I will not go into a shop and buy a single-use 500 ml plastic bottle. It's a fucking nightmare. And now we have the fucking face masks. Are you joking? Never mind. I mean, that's why I have mental health issues. Is to think of. That's why Jeff's passed out. He doesn't even want to be part of this conversation. He can't even believe that that's happening. But you know what I mean? Can you agree? And people just don't realize it. Never mind our reusable shopping bags, which is lacquer, and we forget that often. I literally forget it 90% of the time. So I'm not preaching. Like we just can we just switch on our brains and do that? And please just.
I agree with you. And I think that ties into the muso thing. I mean, we've spoken to a few musos tonight. It's small steps. You know, it's like if you want to lose weight, You want to lose it right away, but there's no way to do that.
Yeah.
You have to take small steps and change in your diet, and small steps eventually have a result, you know. And it's the same with making those kind of environmental choices.
Yeah.
But I think also for musicians right now, artists right now, we have zero support from the government, right? very little. There was piece of paper with a few people that are getting, but so that it is what it is, and therefore start making those small steps. You know, and I'll certainly, I don't know if I can commit to never ever buying a plastic bottle again.
Yeah, of course.
But I'm going to try. I mean, I agree with you. It's just a step in that direction, and one step forward, two steps back, three steps forward, one step back.
Exactly.
Before you know it, you've moved away from where you were, you know, and it feels like you're not moving.
Yeah.
In the beginning, but it's just, if you believe it and you think in that direction, things do start changing.
100%, Karen. Thank you.
Your
thank
actions
you.
Start changing when you.
No, seriously, and I'm sorry. So, because we did vow to keep the tone up, but also, you know, we do have a responsibility. You know, you created a voice that South Africans resonate with, as have I, and so we have the ability to at least change a couple of listeners' like outlook tonight and go. Just don't. Are you ever not going to buy it? No, of course you're going to be at an engine on a road trip and you need some water and you're thirsty. So my suggestion for that is, if you do that, please really buy the 1 liter. First of all, your body's going to love you more. You're going to drink more of it. Don't, these little 500ml bottles, guys, if you care about your kids seeing the world, never mind going on the ocean with on the Impossible Machine and writing a song with Karen and I one day. Please don't fucking buy those things anymore. They are disgusting. If you see anyone do that, I give you full right to be a vegan in that regard. You can say, hey, what the fuck, Marco? That's the only time I allow you to be as judgy as a vegan is when you see someone with those plastic bottles and those reusable masks. Karen, how are you holding out? Are you good? Have we bored you to tears? People are loving it. The viewership is... It's still good. Really good.
I'm loving it.
Okay. Good.
I've almost got to go. I can spend a few more minutes with you, but I got to go. I got to do my.
I understand.
Do my thing over here.
I understand. No. It's been a pleasure. It's been such a pleasure. So what we need to do is we need to decide where that 5,000 rand is going to go. And I've just shared the link of the legendary company that has made it possible. While you're thinking about it, Karen, give me 2 seconds. I am going to wax lyrical about them. So this company called PayJustNow.com, it's a free app. And as you install it and download it, it gives you instant credit. And they're partnered with really big retailers. So you can walk into like a Cape Union Mart and go and buy anything from there. And your first installment is a third of what the cost of it is. And then you pay it off in another 2 installments and it's all interest free. So they've made an arrangement with the retailers. They've absorbed the percentage and the interest. So you, as the consumer, never have to pay interest on what you buy, which I think in this day and age, I have used it myself. I bought a pair of Salomons the other day just to test the system and make sure it's cool. They are legends. They're very cool. And they have sponsored the show. So I thank them very much. And they've given away 5,000 rand cash tonight. That now, Karen, can I not use the reverb button for this one? Have you thought about...
You can do whatever you want to. Do it.
Who have you decided to give the 5,000 rand to? Okay, they went on too long. They went on way too long.
Okay. I do want to give it to Crescentia, mm-hmm. because I do want her to buy her child the DJ gear.
Okay, cool.
I do want to give it to her. I do also want to say to my fellow musicians that I know how difficult times are. We've all been affected by the pandemic. Performers, hairdressers, dancers, singers, musos. We're the last of the last to come out of lockdown. But many of these things have happened before in our industry. We used to sell CDs and make a lot of money off them, and then it turned to downloads and streaming. And then we had to adapt and change our strategy. And I think to keep looking at the past of how things were is not the right thing. We are creative people and we can harness our creativity in new ways, and we should, and we should support creativity. Handouts should be given to mothers, children, and the elderly. We can work, we cannot play music and make money off music in the same way as before, but we can stand together and we can innovate, such as you are doing tonight here, Art, and it's wonderful to be on your show. And we are not beggars, we are not vagabonds, we are not vagrants, we are artists, and we have the power. We have the power to innovate. We have creativity, and let it flow. Let it flow into new areas, and let's figure this out instead of waiting for somebody to save us. The government is not going to save us. The pandemic is not going to end tomorrow. The music industry is not going to transform tomorrow. But we as individuals suddenly have a different power than we had 10, 20 years ago. So that is what I would like to say. And I'm not saying that's easy for me. It's not easy. It's hard. But I don't want to be a busking almost beggar. I don't think we need to go there. I think there are ways, and there are people innovating and doing things. And yeah, let's help each other to keep working. We don't need handouts. Those things have to go to the needy, and we are not the needy. And that's my opinion with respect to everybody that is going through a difficult time right now.
Yeah,
we are not dying of AIDS. We are not sick. We are not 82 years old with no food. We can do this.
Yeah. No, I totally agree. Those are wise words. So Crescentia has already responded saying thank you so much. Crescentia, please let this moment be made known. You need to email the legend Mark. Here we go. Here's the email address, mark@pagejustnow.com. He is going to sort you out with that money. And Karen and I are going to ask you, and the whole audience are going to ask you, that you please validate this request and show us what you've done with that $5,000. That'll be cool. You know, if you don't, it's your own journey. It's all good. There's no judgment. We're not coming after you. We have other things to do, such as surviving and overcoming all sorts of things that are happening in this day and age. Karen, thank you for choosing that. I think it's rad. Thank you for your beautiful words of wisdom. It's a crazy time.
And
if
I can just ask all my fans that are watching right now, please follow Art. Please support his brilliant concept. Every time you follow any of our artists in South Africa, you are supporting us and our families.
Yeah.
And this is a wonderful man with a big heart. And thanks to everybody but hit those follow buttons and follow my friend. He likes to chat and he's free. And yeah, you're gonna find conversations you will not see anywhere else.
Karen, you've been an angel. Thank you for doing that. Thank you for sharing. You have such a big platform. Strength for your next season. Hopefully I can come back and on your show. But mainly before that, I want you to come and test drive the Impossible Machine, and maybe we can do it. We do our next little podcast from there, and mainly just lach, keep it light, and just be strong, Karen. As you know, as you've said, we're all going to get through this. This too shall pass, you know.
Yeah, power to you, brother. I love you.
You too, darling. Lots of love.
Mwah.
Cheers, Karen.
Cheers.
Bye. I actually need to take a bit of a breather. That got a bit emotional there for a bit. Sure, that's very sweet. All right, if anyone else wants to call in and talk, otherwise I'm just going to talk a bit of doo-doo for a little while longer. I've shown you guys, check it all. This is a great comment, but it's far too long to put on the screen. Let's see what it'll look like. It'll probably be terrible. It's too much. Okay. Oh, yeah. You can't see that except it's a pretty face and all the text that needs to happen on there. Guys, the biggest thing you can do for artists in this day and age, as Karen said, is just share the stuff. Let people know about these innovative ways of earning another living. I can't wait to see you live. I know Karen can't wait to be performing live. We're all dying. We're all frothing. Everyone's going through shit. And just know that you're not alone. The mental health thing is a proper thing. We're all experiencing it, and again, you're not alone. Everyone's going through it, so never ever think that you're alone in general, just in what you're going through is basically the message. And I just want to tell you, please do the best you can. We've got some environmental stuff we really need to look at. Please don't use these reusable masks. I think it's terrible. I know they're cheap and it's a quick fix, but I've got a cloth mask that you just use. Just go and just wash it every day and use that. That's our next pandemic, which we don't want. Apart from that, I know we're all going through a lot of cuck. I can't thank you enough. I've got some beautiful guests coming up next week, which I will post about. And it's just been amazing. I really want to thank pagejustnow.com for supporting the show. Marshall Music, Dan Marshall, as always, for supporting. And then Yamaha Music South Africa for supporting all sorts of tools of the trade in order to make this happen. But this couldn't happen without you. Please share it. please be safe, please be sane, and I hope to see you on the next show. Thank you so much for this. This is just really, really rad. You guys rock. I don't know. That left me, maybe it was whiskey, but I doubt it. I think it was just cool. Love you. Cheers. Have a good one.